was a science fiction movie about a device which electronically injected thoughts into the human mind. In this scene, the mind control machine projects images into the brain of the chief scientist through an electrode headset. The scientist then finds himself experiencing the thoughts of a wild truck ride. But even in this futuristic Hollywood tale, the subject still had to be connected to the machine by an electrode headset.
That's remarkable.
But not as remarkable as a real-life experiment where I was the subject of a prototype device designed to project images into the mind without electrodes. The prototype machine, developed from Soviet scientific data, could, according to some scientists, have a profound effect as a weapon of war. Electronic mind control research is not new. A scientific milestone in this area came in the 1960s, when Dr. Jose Delgado demonstrated remote control over a charging bull. By connecting a radio antenna to electrodes inserted into the bull's brain, Delgado proved that the animal's aggressive impulses could be thwarted by electronically manipulating the bull's muscle reflexes.
Do you realize the fantastic possibilities if from the outside we could modify the inside? Could we give messages to the inside? But the beauty is that now we are not using electrodes.
In recent years, Delgado has shown that the behavior of monkeys can be altered using low-power pulsating magnetic fields. But in these experiments, there were no antenna implants.
Any function in the brain, emotions, intellect, personality, well, could be perhaps modified by this non-invasive technology.
Delgado's research has so far been limited to animals. But in the Soviet Union, a radio frequency, or RF device, has been used for over 30 years to manipulate the moods of mental patients. It's called a LIDA machine. It radiates pulses of radio frequency energy, as well as light, sound, and heat. The pulse rate is in the extremely low frequency range, between 0 and 100 pulses per second. Dr. Ross Ady is the top researcher at the Veterans Administration Hospital in Loma Linda, California. He has been investigating the effects of the LIDA machine.
Now, what do the Soviets use this machine for?
Well, they don't use it anymore. We should be very clear that this is a machine which is regarded by them as somewhat obsolete technologically.
This scientist, who did not want his identity revealed, is employed by the U.S. government and has done secret RF weapons research. He believes that tests done with the LIDA and similar machines prove that humans are susceptible to remote alterations of mood and awareness.
Certain kinds of weak electromagnetic signals work exactly like drugs. And so the promise is that anything you can do with drugs, you could do with the right electromagnetic signals. Apparently, there are specific sites involved, specific functions involved. It's a matter of matching up, just like it is with a pill or a drug to cause and effect. You could have a cause and effect relationship between a magnetic field and a biological function.
CNN enlisted the help of noted physicist Dr. Elizabeth Rauscher and electrical engineer Bill Van Buys to build and test an RF mind interference machine from data found in Soviet scientific literature. The machine itself was inexpensive and easy to construct using parts from a consumer electronics store. It emits a weak magnetic field, pulsed at extremely low frequency. As the subject of the test, I was blindfolded and my ears were blocked to prevent inadvertent clues as to what was happening. A magnetic probe was placed about 18 inches from my head. As the experiment began, two signal generators produced waveform patterns that were transmitted by the magnetic probe at about 1/1000th of the Earth's natural magnetic field strength.
Describe anything that you see, if any.
In the control room, Van Buys varied the waveforms being generated. In another room, I could see waveforms changing shape in my mind.
Parabola just went by?
Parabola just went by.
Oh, yeah, I did. I just flipped the switch. Parabola?
Uh-huh.
All right. Well, yes. Let's see. Check this out. That's what happened. I just flipped the switch.
Okay.
There's a spike right there.
Spike. Right there.
Light spike.
I dramatically changed the generator. I stepped it by 10 right here. And the intermix from the two generators was right where you said that you saw
a spike.
Van Buy says that when I failed to see any change, it was because he had not set the proper frequency and power levels. Later, I asked Van Buy what a weapon using this technology could do.
Induce
basically what would be considered hallucinations in people, direct them to do things against their so-called better judgment.
How easy would it be to assemble a weapon from existing off-the-shelf parts?
In 3 weeks, I could put together a weapon that would take care of a whole town.
We showed the results of our test to Dr. Robert Becker, a two-time Nobel nominee for his work in the biological effects of electromagnetism.
This is a very significant experiment because it carries our understanding of how vision is actually performed a step further into the mystery.
He said he thought the machine caused a disturbance in the brain's interpretation of vision, and as such could be used as a weapon.
That kind of a disturbance in the visual system could markedly influence the operations of fighter pilot, helicopter pilot, or an aberration in the visual field as making everyone seeing double, or everyone having their visual field jitter like a poorly adjusted television screen. The effect upon the efficiency with which an army, an air force, or a navy would operate would be catastrophic.
More about RF weapons in my next report. Chuck DiCaro, CNN, Special Assignments.
Described as Radio Shack parts that anybody can build, done in a laboratory.